Prophet Muhammad. Muslims believe in the same prophets mentioned in the Jewish and Christian traditions, including Prophet Noah, Moses, Abraham, and Prophet Jesus, peace be upon them all. They were sent with the same general message: to worship God alone without partners, sons, or daughters, and to follow God's commandments. Before Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, prophets were only sent to a particular people in particular places and periods. However, Prophet Muhammad is the last and final prophet who is meant for all humankind until the end of time. Prophet Jesus was sent after Prophet Moses to reform Judaism, to reinstate the rule of the divine, and to sweep away all innovations introduced after Prophet Moses had passed. But Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, was rejected by the majority of his people who tried to crucify him. The Israelites and the Roman authorities could not harm Prophet Jesus as God raised him to the heavens. He departed saying, "But very truly I tell you, it is for your good that I am going away. Unless I go away, the Advocate will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you." John 16:7. Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, was referring to the prophet that was coming after him, Prophet Muhammad. Such like how Prophet Jesus came to reform the previous message sent before him by the previous prophet, Musa, peace be upon him, Prophet Muhammad came to reform Prophet Jesus' message since it was well distorted by his followers and did not survive in its original form. Prophet Jesus stated, "I still have many things to tell you, but you can't bear them now. When the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into all the truth. For he will not speak on his own, but he will speak whatever he hears. He will also declare to you what is to come." John 16:13. Prophet Jesus Christ hinted that God would reveal another book and messenger. The man that Jesus prophesied was Prophet Muhammad, who was the Paraclete, the Comforter, the Helper, the Admonisher, sent by God after Prophet Jesus. Prophet Jesus spoke of Prophet Muhammad in John 16:14, stating, "He shall glorify me, for he shall receive of mine and shall show it unto you." This prophecy applies to Prophet Muhammad, to whom was the Holy Quran was revealed to, from God, to guide people unto the truth. O our people, respond to the Messenger of Allah and believe in him. Allah will forgive you of your sins and protect you from a painful punishment. Quran 46:31. God speaks to Moses, "I will raise for them, the Israelites, a prophet like you from among their brothers, the Israelites. I will put my words in his mouth, and he will tell them, the Israelites, everything I command him." Deuteronomy 18:18. The Christians mistakenly believe this prophecy refers to the Prophet Jesus because Prophet Jesus was like Prophet Moses. In a way, they were both Jews and both were prophets. However, if you are looking at only those two criteria, then all prophets of the Bible who came after Prophet Moses, such as Prophet Isaiah, Daniel, Joel, etc., will fulfill this prophecy since all of them were Jews and prophets. It is indeed Prophet Muhammad who is like Prophet Moses, as the verse stated. But Prophet Muhammad and Prophet Moses had a father and mother, whereas Prophet Jesus had no father. Both prophets were also married and had children, whereas Prophet Jesus did not marry nor have kids according to the Bible. Both Prophet Muhammad and Moses, peace be upon them, died natural deaths, whereas Prophet Jesus was raised in the heavens by God. Prophet Muhammad is from among the brethren of Prophet Moses, because Arabs are brethren of Jews. Prophet Abraham had two sons, Ishmael and Isaac, peace be upon them. The Arabs are the descendants of Prophet Ishmael, and the Jews are descendants of Prophet Isaac. Prophet Muhammad was unlettered, who didn't know how to read, write, and calculate, so his revelation would come straight from God verbatim, as the verse stated. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was born about 507 years after the birth of Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him. He was born in Mecca, in the Arabian Peninsula, the people of Mecca were devoted to idol worshippers, and the area and period at the time were full of ignorance, foolishness, and misguidance. At 40, Prophet Muhammad received his first revelation in a cave from God via the angel Gabriel. He then spent the remaining portion of his life explaining and living the teachings of the Holy Quran and Islam, the religion that God revealed to him. Although he was known among his community as the truthful, the trustworthy, the majority of people did not believe him or his message. Soon after, a massive campaign started to persecute those who believed in the message. After 13 years of preaching in the city of Mecca, Prophet Muhammad migrated to the city of Medina, where he gained some followers. The followers made him leader of the city. The disbelievers of Mecca plotted and attempted to attack the faith sent from God. However, what was originally a small group of Muslims grew in number, and they could withstand the attack of the disbelievers. Within 10 years, the Prophet himself led an army back to Mecca and conquered it in a bloodless victory. Later, Islam spread throughout the world. Prophet Muhammad died in 632. God states in the Quran that he did not send Prophet Muhammad except as a mercy for humanity. And we have not sent you, O Muhammad, except as a mercy to the worlds. Quran 21:107. The Prophet was sent to guide humanity. Prophet Muhammad understood the Quran. He loved the Quran, and he lived his life based on the principles of the Quran and its standards. He is the world's best role model for all humankind. He is the one with outstanding virtues and characteristics. He was an astonishing husband, father, grandfather, leader, teacher, judge, and statesman. He preached justice, fairness, peace, and love. Muslims attempt to emulate the Prophet Muhammad's faith, behavior, attitude, patience, charity, compassion, righteousness, and piety. The act of emulating the Prophet is called sunnah. The term sunnah is a concept that means the way or practice of. The meaning of sunnah is generally understood as through act of doing whatever the Prophet said, did, or approved. Sunnah is the way of the practice of Prophet Muhammad. Muslims emulate the way the Prophet ate, drank, the position he slept on, the way he behaved and interacted with others, etc. Following the Sunnah, the way of the Prophet, would make one's life in this world and the next easier. Islam is such a natural way of life that its rules, regulations, and recommendations become easy to adopt. Islam is not merely a religion, it's a way of life, a holistic approach designed by the Almighty to benefit the one that follows it. The comprehensiveness of Islam allows every intention, word, or action in life to be an act of worship, where one gains reward from the Almighty from praying to God, giving charity, helping others, eating, drinking, or even sleeping. There has certainly been, for you in the Messenger of Allah, an excellent pattern for anyone whose hope is in Allah and the Last Day, and who remembers Allah often. Quran 33:21. Prophet Muhammad is undoubtedly one of the most influential figures in history whose life, actions, and thoughts changed the world. When Muslims declare their faith in one God, they also maintain their belief in the last and final messenger, Muhammad, peace be upon him. Muslims believe in Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. They love him, they respect him, they obey him, and they follow him to the best of their ability. They hold him in such high regard that for many it is emotionally painful to see or hear their beloved prophet and teacher ridiculed, disrespected, demeaned, scorned, or mocked. Whereas Muslims look up to Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, they do not worship or attribute any divine characteristics to him. Certain people mistakenly assume that Muslims worship Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, by formulating a false analogy. Since Christians worship Prophet Jesus, they presume Muslims worship Prophet Muhammad, hence incorrectly naming the followers of Islam to Mohammedans. Muslims understand that Prophet Muhammad is only a man and was sent from God. Though Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is a man worthy of our utmost attention, respect, and love, the man who will stand before God on the day of judgment and beg God to have mercy on us, the one that will intercede for us on the day of judgment. Muslims love and respect him because he is the slave and messenger of God who was chosen to be the last and final prophet whom the Almighty sent to humanity, whose mission will continue until the last day.